Hello everyone, good morning, afternoon or evening depending on what time you are watching this. In this video, I'll guide you through how to use Filmora. So let's get started. Filmora is a video editing software with a lot of built-in functionalities to help you produce amazing videos. To begin, we will look at how to import videos, pictures or audio tracks into Filmora. The first method is to double click here on the media section of the Filmora. You double click here and you'll be able to select a video, an audio or a picture that you want to upload to Filmora. That's one method. Another way is to click on the import button and you'll be able to select something. The third method by which you can upload a video, a picture or an audio into Filmora is going directly into your Windows Explorer, then locating the item you want to upload and dragging, then you drop into Filmora. So these are ways in which you can upload or import videos, audios or pictures into Filmora before starting to edit them. So this major section gives you information on all the documents you have in Filmora. That is, here you can find sample colors, you can find sample videos that you can download to make your videos more interesting. But at this point in time, we are not really interested into that because we basically want to just record our screen and be able to do a few edits. So we won't really need these aspects. So I go back to my media section where I find all my uploads. So at this point we are more interested in knowing how to record our screen. So to be able to record our screen, we move on to this record button with the drop down arrow. We have record from webcam, we have record from PC screen and we have record voiceover. To be able to record both our screen and ourselves, just like I am doing right now, we have to select record PC screen. When we click on record PC screen, we have this window which appears. Let me locate it well, and I am currently recording myself, so I'll increase it. And we have these various options. So we have full screen. I can't edit it now, I can't modify it because I'm currently recording myself, but if I wasn't recording myself, you have the possibility to either put full screen, either put custom. Maybe you don't want these edges down, you don't want this section down to be shown in your video. You can modify all that by putting custom and using the drag and drop options to choose the part of your screen that you want to display. Here we have save to, which is basically where your video track will be saved. I mean the video recording will be saved. Then all of these have to be the same here, the best quality. And to be able to record from your webcam, you have to check this box. You have to check this board, record the camera stream. Once you check the box, you go and you select USB webcam. You select from your webcam. Once that is done, you have the possibility to drag and drop your video and position it to wherever you want. And you can also resize it. So that's basically how you do to record your screen and your webcam. So once that is done, to start your recording, you can either press here or you press F9. Then if while doing your recording you want to pause, you can press F10, and then to resume is still F10. And when you are done recording and you want to stop your video, you can press F9. So that's how you can record your screen and your webcam. Once you press F9, your video recording will automatically be uploaded into Filmora and it will appear somewhere here. Now you have the possibility to drag and drop it into your timeline to start your video edit. So now let's look at the timeline. Let's know more about the timeline. This is the timeline in Filmora and this is where all the video editing is being done. So to be able to edit a video, the first thing you have to do is to import or to add all the elements you would like to edit into your video into the timeline. So if I want this picture, I drag and drop it into my timeline. Maybe I want this other picture as well, I drag and drop it. And I want this background audio, I drag and drop it. So The timeline is divided into two sections. As we can see here, we have the video section and we have the audio track. So everything related to visual, like pictures, videos, you'll be able to add them in the video track, and anything related to audio, you'll be able to add them in the audio track. So at some point in your video, you would like to superpose. Maybe at this point in time, I want that when my video is playing up here, I superpose this picture on this video. So we see that at that point, a new video track was created. But in Filmora, you have the possibility to superpose on a video or on a picture as many times as you want. So if I want to superpose again and again, each time I do that, a new video track is created. This is the same with audio track. Like if I want to superpose an audio track, I just do that and we see that other tracks are being created. So we will have an unlimited number of tracks. So I will delete that and we will move forward. So as I said, we'll look more into the timeline, how to edit the video, how to walk through the timeline. So here we have our undo and our redo buttons that one all of us know the use. Then to be able to delete something, if you want to delete, you can click the item you want to delete and that's the delete key that becomes highlighted. So you can also go into cropping. You can crop and resize your image. You can do that. You can change the sizes, you can say original ratio or whatsoever, and then you have the possibility to crop and resize. I'll just cancel. Then you have the possibility to use advanced color tools to modify the lighting and a few things on the pictures. We will not be working on that. So a few other things, we have the timer for the duration. You can make your video track to go faster or slower. We have a bookmark option to put some bookmark on your video to remind you of maybe where you are or what you have to do there. So if I add a bookmark here, I have the possibility to name it, maybe I say reminder, and at this point in time I have to add a comment, remember to add an image here or a title here. So this is how you can work with bookmarks. Maybe when I will be editing my video, I'll come here at this point and I'll have that bookmark telling me, I have to remember to add a title at that point. Then we will look at this section, which is where we can have our preview. Like when you are editing or when you are playing your video, you see it appears up here. So this is where you see your preview of your video before you go into exporting it and producing a final video. So here you can either enlarge it to see it on a larger screen or you can work with it like this, so that as you are doing the edit, you are watching the video simultaneously. Also, you might want to make a screenshot of your video at some point, so you just use this option, you just use this button here, and you'll be able to capture the screen. So let's look at how to cut. Like you might be doing a video and at some point you say something that you weren't supposed to say, or you make a mistake and you don't want it to appear in your video. You can simply use your pointer to cut at some point. So let me say I want to cut here. So I put my pointer exactly where I want to cut and I just click on this scissors, and my picture, or if it's a video or something else, we see that it's been splitted. If I'm now free to delete this if I want, or if the part I wanted to delete is just in between, so I can just come here and I still press the same thing and my track splitted into three. Now if I want to delete this part that had the mistake, I am free to either press the delete key on your keyboard or this button and it is deleted. So I can come back here, collect this and attach it to the previous one, so you will not notice that I cut something in this video or in this picture. Same thing goes with videos and audios. So if I want to cut some at some point in my audio, I just place my pointer exactly where I want to cut. I press the scissors, then I go maybe to the other part, I suppress the scissors, and I'll be able to delete whatever is in between. So at this we see that the audio track is too long and I don't use most of it, so I'll just delete this part with the delete key on my keyboard. So this is my video, or this is what I'm left with. So you'll be able to cut, split, and do any other thing that you like to do on the video. So another thing I would like to show before we move to something else is we see that our picture does not take the complete screen. We have some black, some dark edges. So to be able to modify that, you select, you double tap on the picture, and you see these buttons will appear for you to enlarge. So you enlarge until your picture or your video, depending on what you are working on, covers the screen entirely. Once that is done, you see that we now see that our picture is on full screen. Same thing with this one. You can come and you click on it, then you enlarge it, so it makes your video look more professional and more interesting actually. So that's a bit about the timeline, how to work out with the timeline. Then we will look at how to let's look at how to modify audio. We see this audio track this background music is pretty loud, so I'll go in to modify it and maybe reduce the volume. On the audio track, you see a long horizontal line. This is the line that controls the audio, the volume. So to be able to have a reduced volume, you just drag and you drop the volume, and if we listen again, we see that the volume has greatly been reduced. So you can do that to work out with your volume. Okay, also at some point you might want to fade your volume out or in. Like if you are just copying a given part of an audio track, it is likely that you cut the audio track abruptly, and you don't like your listeners to know that you cut the audio track abruptly. So what you do is you use the fade in and fade out option. So if I double tap on this audio track, I'll get to the settings section where I'll have the fade out option. The fade out option is helps you in such a way that it makes your audio track to gradually decrease, the volume to gradually decrease until the end of the audio track, preventing things like an abrupt stop in your audio track. Let's see if we have something like that here. So we see that this audio track just ends very abruptly. So to prevent this, we can use the fade out option. We put a few seconds, and if you check into your timeline, you see that it's shown in that kind of a diagram appears here to see how the fade out option will look like. So if I play it from now, we see that the music reduces gradually, and you can even increase the radius of fading. So that it starts reducing from an even greater period, and it goes down gradually, not more abruptly. You can do the same thing with fading in, so that it does not just start from if maybe you cut the video, or if you cut the audio track from somewhere it is not starting from the beginning. You can just use the fade in option, just like the fade out option, to be able to work through your audio, making it sound more interesting. Okay, the last thing we will look at in the audio track is how to change the pitch. If maybe while playing your audio, a certain part is lower in volume than another, and you would like to make everything to be at the same level, or you would like to increase your pitch at some point in the video, you have the possibility, or you have the option, to either cut, like split your audio track into two, then increase the volume of one, so that you see here the audio track is lower, the audio is lower, but here the audio is higher. So you have the possibility to do this, and your video will be good to go. So that's the last thing we are going to see on the timeline. So now let's move on to adding audios, title, transitions, and effects to your videos. So for the audio parts, Filmora proposes you its bank of audios. You can come here and you download any audio that you would like to use, any background music, a beat, or interesting background sound that you like to use for your videos. But if you are not interested in using any of these, you can just maybe download your own from YouTube, download your own from any other source, and you'll be able to add to your video. But take care. There are a lot of copyright claims. That is, whenever you use a background music for your video, make sure it is in no copyright, or you have a license to be able to use that background music. So we move now to titles, adding titles to your videos. So again, Filmora proposes a huge bank of titles. You can have let me take this title. You just have to download. Once the download is complete, you are able to use the title anywhere in your video. So let me play the video, and at the point where the title appears, at the point where I imported the title will appear on my screen. So to be able to modify the title, you double click on it, then you open. Okay, so here I can modify my title. I'll say how to use Filmora. So that is my title. You can change the size, the font size, you can change the font, you can bold, you can change the alignment, and a lot of other things. So we are just interested in knowing how to write our title, maybe changing the font size, and even the color of the text. So these are a few things you can do with Filmora. Once you have written your title, you can just press OK, and we have our title, how to use Filmora. We see here that this title option provides another type, which says your text here. If you don't have any other thing to say, or let me say by Mohammed, yeah, and I press OK. But if you don't have any other thing to say, you can just click this and remove it from your screen, so that the people watching your videos won't see it anymore. But let me just undo and bring it back. So if I play this, we have the title that displays how to use Filmora by Mohammed. We see that this title has exceeded to the next slide. So to prevent that, we monitor this with our pointer. We locate the point where this particular screen ends. Once that is done, we see that our title has exceeded, and we use our cursor to bring it back, to trim it until the end of the first track. So once that is done, we play, and we see that as soon as the first track ends, our title ends with it as well. So you have a lot of titles options. You just have to download, and once that is done, you can use them at any point in time in your videos. Okay, transitions make your videos look more interesting. Let me go back to my media and I will add this again to the timeline. So at this point, if I play the video, let me reduce the sound. Okay, so at this point, playing the video, we see that the picture changes from one to another, and it is kind of sudden. So transitions helps you put a very interesting way of living from one picture or one slide to another. There are a lot of different transitioning options you can use for your videos. So once you click on a transition, you choose where you want your transition to appear, and if we play this again, we see a transition has been applied. So transitions make your video to be smooth. So that's basically it for transitions. As I said, Filmora has a huge bank of different transitioning options for you to make your videos more attractive. So you might want to add a few effects like segmentation or blurring at some point in your video. You'll be able to do that with Filmora. So if I play the video after adding this blur, you'll see that I have this effect on my video. So all of this is thanks to Filmora. And again, you can trim it if you don't want it to last for too long. Maybe you just want it to be at the beginning. Then after a few seconds, it is gone. So there are a lot of effects you can add to your videos to make them more interesting. Like if I have this option, I put it here. Once the download is complete, I'll be able to play my track, and at that point I have the option. Okay, the picture is big, so let me reduce the picture. So we have the effect applied. It was because the picture was pretty large, that's why we could not see it. So these are a few effects, and you can take your time and go through all the various options, various possibilities that Filmora gives you. So at this point, we have gone through the basic things about Filmora. So we will now see how to export our videos. So once we are done editing, we come here to the export button, and we have to add a few settings. Here we will put the name of our video. Maybe I'll say how. Then I'll select where I want to save it. Then you choose the settings for the resolutions. Here you can choose good, better, or best depending on what you want. The video will actually behave according to the one you select here. So once that is done, just click on OK. And here we see that we will be uploading in MP4, but you can change it to whatsoever you want. If you want an MP3, if you want MP4, you can just make the selection here. Once your settings are okay, you just click on export and your video will start exporting. So once the export is done, you'll be able to check it in the folder where you saved the video. So I'll close it here. So this is basically it for this video, but before we end, I'll just go through a few more interesting options that Filmora proposes. While working on Filmora, it automatically saves your work, even if you have never created a file before. Like we see here, I have untitled. I haven't saved this work yet, but if my computer crashes or goes off, when I open Filmora, I'll have the possibility to retrieve all of the work I was doing, which is very interesting about Filmora. So though it does that, always have the habit to save your work as you proceed. So to save your work, you can come to the file section and save your project, then give it a name. You click on save project, then you give it a name. That's the name I give to my project, and I save. So now my project has a name, how to use Filmora. So make use of all these options. Also, once you save your project, you can close Filmora and get access to your project at any time you would like to use it. Another interesting option is that once you save your project, for someone who does not have a paid account, if you render or if you export your video, you have a watermark at the end, or you have a watermark throughout your video. So to maybe if you know someone, or in our case, as we have a paid account, you might want to complete the editing of your video. Then using your free account, you can complete the editing of your video. Then you share the project with someone who has the paid account. That is, as we've saved here, we saved the project. So you go into your computer and copy the project and share it with someone who has the paid account. Once I have access to the project, I just upload it into the paid version that I am using, and I'll be able to export your video, your edited video, without the watermark. So that is also very, very useful. So this is basically it for this video, and I hope this video was helpful, and I am open to any question. If you like any more explanation about how to use Filmora, just send a message and I'll be able to reply or give as much more details as possible. Thank you for watching and have a great day. Bye.